Hey everyone, and welcome to our daily devotions for today, Saturday, the 17th of April. We begin, as always, with our opening prayer. Let's pray together. Living God, with joyful hearts, we praise you. For you have destroyed the power of death and opened the way to life. With humble hearts, we acclaim you. For you have vanquished evil, good refusing to be denied. With grateful hearts we acknowledge you, for you have turned defeat into victory, ends into new beginnings. With reverent hearts we honour you, for you have changed our lives forever, making this and every day a celebration of Easter. Living God, for the triumph you achieved and the victory you go on achieving, we magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Romans chapter 4. It was not through the law that Abraham and his offspring received the promise that he would be heir of the world, but through the righteousness that comes by faith. For if those who depend on the law are heirs, faith means nothing, and the promise is worthless, because the law brings wrath. And where there is no law, there is no transgression. Therefore, the promise comes by faith, so that it may be by grace and may be guaranteed to all Abraham's offspring, not only to those who are of the law, but also to those who have the faith of Abraham. He is the father of us all. As it is written, I have made you a father of many nations. He is our father in the sight of God, in whom he believed, the God who gives life to the dead and calls into being things that were not. Against all hope, Abraham in hope believed, and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been said to him, so shall your offspring be. Without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and that Sarah's womb was also dead. Yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened in his faith, and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God had power to do what he had promised. This is why it was credited to him as righteousness. The words, "it was credited to him," were written not for him alone, but also for us, to whom God will credit righteousness, for us who believe in him who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead. He was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification.
As we think about our salvation, we praise the name of Jesus as we sing together. Jesus is Lord, creation's voice proclaims it.
Jesus is Lord, creation's voice proclaim it, for by his power each tree and flower was planned and made. Jesus is Lord, the universe declares it, sun, moon and stars in heaven cry, Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord, praise him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, yet from his throne eternal, in flesh he came to die in pain on Calvary's tree. Jesus is Lord, from him all life proceeds, yet gave his life a ransom the setting us free. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. Praise Him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, O sin, the mighty conqueror. From death He rose, and all His foes shall own His name. Jesus is Lord, God sent His Holy Spirit to show by works of power that Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. Praise Him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. Praise Him with hallelujahs, for Jesus is Lord.
Psalm 118. Open for me the gates of the righteous. I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, through which the righteous may enter. I will give you thanks, for you answered me. You have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. The Lord has done it this very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad. Lord, save us. Lord, grant us success. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. From the house of the Lord we bless you. The Lord is God, and he has made his light shine on us. With boughs in hand, join in the festal procession up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, and his love endures forever.
We come now to our closing prayer for today. Let's pray together. Gracious God, we read in Scripture of human estrangement from you in the Garden of Eden, of how sin and disobedience estrange us from you and from one another. But today we celebrate how Mary met the risen Christ in another garden, joyfully recognizing there the one who, in dying and rising, bridged that barrier between us, offering forgiveness, a fresh start, and new life. We thank you for the immensity of his sacrifice and for the wonder of his gift, for opening up the gateway to Eden for all people. Amen.